Now we've got a little mini hit on our hands. We're panicking. Hi, this is Sonique, and this is the story of It Feels So Good.
And that's what takes us high.
First woman who actually discovered it, she was in the, that's when I was homeless and was living in the YMCA. And I was playing pool. And she goes, "You've got a lovely voice." And then she said, "Oh, I know this band is looking for a singer." And then I was just at that age, I was 16. And I was thinking, you know, you need to do something that's brave. That's a brave thing to do. I'd actually done a song and it was called Let Me Hold You.
Let me hold you, let me squeeze you.
And it literally sounded like that, like this tiny voice I had. My plan was not to sing and DJ. I knew what the people wanted. Like, I felt that, like, every record that I wanted to listen to, it seemed like they wanted to listen to it as well. And everybody wanted to dance, and I wanted to dance, so it just all made sense to me. Like, well, let's just give it a go. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work, you know? It was really nice at that time as well, watching that dance scene be created, because it was being created at that time. Things like Gatecrashers and we had Cream, places like Club UK, the Manumission and Ibiza. And so we were discovering a lot of fresh music. That's when I wrote Feel So Good. There was a guy called Linus Murdoch. He had a track and it was a drum and bass track. And I was very, really into drum and bass at the time. And I said, oh, you know, I'll write something for this. And I wrote Feel So Good. But like I said, it was a drum and bass track. So you're not really expecting anything. I liked it. I do remember liking it, but just was like, yeah. Well, 8 years have gone on now. I've got a friend of mine who wants to work with Jules. So I've introduced them together. This is where Sirius becomes a record label. It was actually Simon. So he was the one who was like, oh yeah, I know a really great song we could do. I put a spell on you. You know, he was one of those types. Put a spell on you. So we've done that. Now we've got a little mini hit on our hands. We're panicking. Simon comes around my house and I've got cassettes in a box, you know, and he's going through, we've got to find a track. And I go, well, I've written some songs here. So he says, oh, he starts going through. And then he hears Feel So Good, drum and bass style. And he says, oh, we could do something with this. They did mixes of it. Now I'm at the top of my game as a DJ. I'm a little bit over the top picky now. So I wasn't liking the mixes. I was like, I can't play that. You know, it's not really going to work for my people. So we went back into the studio and did another mix. And I literally took everything out. Sorry, guys, I'm really sorry. But then, you know, it needed that. It needed to take stuff out because to me, the song had so much melody and there was so much going on. Trying to master it. And then I remember saying to put this little bell sound. It was like that. It was getting that particular about it. It was like, ding, dong. Saying that down the phone, I remember. Yeah, now just got to get a little bell that goes ding dong ding ding. I just even now I'm like, but it's important to me, and it just all seemed to make sense. And once I'd done that and I've had the little bell, I was happy. done with the track, you know, I'm ready to move on to whatever. And Simon goes, oh, I think I'm gonna go over to America, see if they like it. It's like, knock yourself out, go for it, you know. He signed it to a tiny label. So we started to get back very positive response because of this track. And then it took 5 minutes for a top label to just go, cha-ching, 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 you know. They didn't have to do much more because it already was gathering this momentum, and it wasn't in England. It was really America, you know, blew up the track. Don't you understand? Do not want to be thrust into the pop, unless that's what you're looking for. But when you're not expecting that to happen and people are really actually looking at you, yeah. No, that was ugly. I just knew it was time for me to stop. Everything was just getting too much.
And with the second biggest selling track of this year, it's Sonique.
What I'm really, really grateful for is the fact that that song is real. You know, it's a real message, and it's a message that matters, and it obviously does. And that's why it touches, and I love the fact that people come back to me and say, thank you for that song.